Well, thanks for joining me. I'm back upon the Quantock Hills. Fancied a stroll. Oh, look who we have here.
Well, I've been jinxing the weather with the puddles, but I think we're all right for tonight.
Yes, yeah. I'm joined by Ant. This is Ant Powell, the Jinx. And we're heading out for a quick one-nighter upon the Quantocks, an area of outstanding national beauty.
Natural
beauty. Did I say national beauty?
You did.
Oh, flippy neck. Anyway, natural beauty. This way. Could be a good place to get some water, Ant.
I'm going to grab some, fine. I'm going to take my little camera off and grab a shot of the
water. I need to filter some water, I didn't bring any. Well, I've got my water and we're just walking on now up to our campsite, which is about another mile and a half, 2 mile up yonder way. What's this area called, Ant?
It's the Quantocks.
The Quantocks. But has this area actually got a name? This specific area?
Yeah, it's a place I like.
That'll do, a place you like.
A place I like.
And you can understand why, because just look at the colours. And we had the sunshine that was out a little while ago. It's gone in again. But everything's now turning, we're getting the autumnal colours. And it's just starting to rain. Really very beautiful. Yeah, you can really appreciate, Ant, why this area is one of your favourite locations, because it is beautiful, isn't it? There's a lot of birch trees in this grove, and some of them, well, most of them actually, have got lichen, moss, fungi, birch polypore, I noticed on one of the trees. So especially with the lichen and the moss, I'm pretty sure indicates a fairly pristine environment, good clean air. Because not far away we've got the Bristol Channel, and that's going to be filtering in fresh air from the Atlantic. Just crossed the ford, thankfully it's only a few inches deep, but it's the only way to get up to the rest of the through the rest of the woodland, I should say. And then about another half a mile, this lovely woodland peters out, and it becomes sort of like quite open, a bit like the moors, Exmoorish, very Exmoorish. Lots of beautiful holly here as well. Berries just coming out. Well, that tree there, possibly one of the last trees. We're leaving the wooded area behind now and heading out into the open ground through a bit of a ravine. bit of a stiff climb ahead, and then we'll be there. Well, here we are. This is the Bicknoller post here. We're going to camp close by, but in the background you can make out some of the hills, and you can make out the sea, the estuary, the Bristol Channel, and Quantock's Head we think is over to the right, around here. Where are we? There. Around here somewhere, we think. That's where Wiltshire is, around the corner. You can see the reason why the air appears so clean. Fresh sea air, isn't it? Well, this is the Bicknoller post. It's even got a clump of fungi at the bottom. There's a fungi here as well, but...
Hello, everybody!
After walking off-piste, so to speak, we've found a piece of land which I think is good enough to camp on. Certainly level, it's very low, close cropped heather. I think we can manage this okay.
A few animal tracks, Andy, but decent.
I think it's alright, isn't it?
It's got beautiful views.
Nice view to wake up to in the morning as well. There's the campsite. There's Ant over there in his Atco, Hilleberg Atco. There's the trusty old Lanshan 1. I've used it quite a lot this year. And there's the view. That's it. I'm in my tent now. It's all set up. Temperature's dropping. Definitely feel that. That biting on the hands. It's going to be quite a chilly night tonight. Anyway, got a summer weight sleeping bag, silk liner, Costco quilt, helium pillow hidden underneath there. So I think I'll be quite warm tonight. And just a wonderful view to look at. Look. There's my little head torch there. But anyway, it's cold. We're going to shut the door, keep the warmth in. It's morning time. Let's have a look out the door. Let's have a look out the door. There's the view that greets me. Not a bad view. Bit chilly though. on the way back now, and we've still got another four miles to walk, haven't we? Aren't? It's been a long hike, this. So
4 miles, about a mile and a half at best.
Yeah, not very far really. We're nearly back at the cars now, but we just found this nice area and just found this in the brew. So we got the stove on. To be honest with you, Ant's a bit of a stoveaholic, and he's really yet to bond with the click stand, which is the stove I'm using. I often get asked a lot about this stove. It was a gift from Noel. Noel's a gentleman. And it's my favourite stove because it's so economical and efficient because of the built-in windscreen. I can just quickly show you that. This is an Evernew titanium pot, 700mm. And then it's got this windscreen around it. That's made from titanium as well. And then you've got this triangular burner, very similar to the Transia triangle, but it's made by a company in the States called Clickstand. They're apparently hard to get hold of, and they're not cheap, but they are very efficient.
Now we just sit waiting.
Taking a long time, isn't it?
Wait for the boil.
Taking a long time. Not far away.
Exactly, you don't do what? Burning your face off.
I think that'll do, aren't?
Yeah, fine, dish up. Chuck me when you chuck me from the cup. Oh, gross.
Hey, I've made you some woodland tea.
I think it's a bit, there's 100% proof that stuff, Sandy, from the appearance.
Woodland.
You wet yourself now.
Yeah, there you go. Made you some woodland tea, sir.
Smashing.
Oh. Say something for me.
Want some, guys?
Yeah.
Lovely woodland brew.